In this lesson, we'll cover Webflow's most misunderstood element, the container, which is designed to keep content from going edge to edge, instead keeping it neatly bound towards the center in a width you can define. So we'll cover the basics of a container, how to create custom widths and classes on our containers. We'll cover padding, how to add extra space inside a container. We'll talk about how to reuse containers to ensure consistency and visual alignment across your site. Enter the container, the perfect companion for a section. And when we place a container inside a section, it's sort of in the way. But when we place content inside the container, notice how it narrows everything and keeps it neatly organized towards the center of the screen. Now, that leads us to custom widths. By default, if you put stuff into the container element, it's automatically responsive. Content like paragraphs, headings, anything that doesn't have a fixed width will respond responsively. But what if we want a wider container instead of the default? Well, at any time, we can set a different maximum width. We can start by adding a class to our container. We'll call it container. And let's set the maximum width here to 1100 pixels. And now it'll still respond to the viewport, but it maxes out at 1100 pixels. Now, if things are getting too close to the edge, we can always add padding on the left and right to add some breathing room there. We'll remove that for now, but we'll come back to this concept a little bit later. For now, let's make sure our nav container, the container in our nav bar, matches the new container class we just created. Now when we change something like the max width, it affects all containers that have the container class applied. But let's add a larger breakpoint. Here's one for 1920. This is usually for larger displays like an iMac or a Pro Display XDR. And the idea here is that things are relatively narrow. Maybe we want our container width to be more appropriately sized for these larger displays. Max width, make the change. That's all we have to do. Now, remember, always go back to the base breakpoint to continue designing and building your project because style changes cascade outwards, whether it's a max width on a container or even something like the color of a button. Those things are styled on the base breakpoint, and those changes cascade downwards towards smaller breakpoints and upwards towards larger breakpoints. And we can use our container to add extra breathing room. This is part three, by the way. With padding, if we look on mobile landscape, for instance, we can see our content is pushed right up to the edge. And in some cases, we might want that. But for us, let's go all the way back to desktop and make sure we have padding added on the left and right. We can adjust by holding Option or Alt and dragging, let's say about 40 pixels on the left and right on desktop. And that'll give us some nice breathing room as we scale down. Maybe we want 20 pixels of breathing room on the tablet breakpoint since we have less screen real estate. And on mobile landscape, 20 might be a bit heavy there. Let's drop to 10 pixels. Same on mobile portrait. In each case, the properties on the larger breakpoints are cascading down to the smaller breakpoints. Part four. And because we already gave our container a class, we can apply that class to other containers we add to our project. And like we covered before, a change to the styling on that class will affect all containers that have that class applied. So, we covered a lot here. We covered the basics, we talked about how we can create a class on a container and set our own custom maximum widths on different breakpoints. We showed adding padding on the left and right to add some breathing room between a container and the edge of the viewport. We applied the container class to other containers to keep things consistent. And that's an overview of containers in the Webflow Designer.